why we never will forget this year. Because John Seaver's smiling face, our leaders, our friends, all the good times,
all the memories,
the bad times we've had together.
Seniors. That is
yeah.
Seniors.
Because
we had fun.
And,
because
everybody's
somehow
excited.
Somehow you don't realize.
That it's over till it's over.
Till your senior year and you can, what are y'all doing?
But just think, you get to go off to college and
what are y'all doing?
Be with all your friends.
That's right.
Meet.
Stephanie Waller.
What are y'all talking about?
Tiffany.
Tiffany.
<Shakira.
laughs>
And
your
they're friends. All friends.
Your letter came to me, saved it in a special place, and read it by the million.
1988 at Hendersonville, a year none of us will ever forget. There were memories in the making everywhere you look, and it was a great year for Commando sports, music, drama, and academics. But what made 1988 really exceptional was the students, the outstanding athletes with the great plays, the honor students with the great grades, and of course, the personalities. The people who make Hendersonville tick are right here. The people behind the scenes who work hard every day to take care of school business, listen to our problems, and help solve them. The school employees, counselors, assistants, and of course, Paul Decker, Hendersonville's principal.
Well, we anticipate having a good school year because of the leadership that we feel like we have in our senior class. A lot of times the direction that the school year goes depends on the seniors, and we feel like we have an outstanding senior class, and we're really looking forward to the school year. We're looking forward to the athletics. We feel like we've got some real potential. We're also looking forward to academics. We're going to be working on getting kids scholarships, and we're going to be working on trying to improve our test scores. And we're looking forward to our arts program. With our music and our drama and our art department. We just feel like we're going to have an outstanding year. We're excited about the school.
Hendersonville means different things to different people, but what most of us got out of 1988 was what we left with, a great education. From math and English to history and science, Hendersonville had some eager students and some great teachers. We all learned a lot, and everybody had a lot of fun in the process. Well, almost everybody. But even though it was tough sometimes, the grades were worth it.
Thank you. Well, this upcoming football season, I think, will be an exciting season. We have a new coach here at Hendersonville, and it's going to take a little time for them to get accustomed to me and for me to get accustomed to them, but that's what makes coaching interesting, I think. Don't have a whole lot of seniors on the team this year, about 13. A lot of juniors and some good-looking sophomores. I think we'll have a good year. I'm looking forward to it, and I'm just as happy as I can be to be at Hendersonville High School.
The 1988 Hendersonville football team made the local fans proud, finishing with a 5-5 record. The Commandos boasted a great defense combined with a running game that kept us in every game. Coach Derrick's senior letterman included James Murph, Brent LaCroix, Scott Heatherly, Jeff Mathis, Trey Adams, Travis Lynch, Kevin Witt, Bill Oliver, Patrick Kiefauber, Kevin Long, Rocky Bruner, Brad Krieger, and Craig McMurtry. They ruled the gridiron and led the team that kept a super football tradition alive at Hendersonville. And let's don't forget this year's football cheerleaders and pom-pom girls. They kept the crowd in the game with some fantastic routines and gave everybody something to cheer about. ...1988 was packed with activity. It was a year that had something for everybody. But wherever you turned, you felt something special in the halls at Hendersonville. Something called spirit.
Well, I poured two drinks and I turned away. Walked to the kitchen, I could hear you.
School spirit was definitely in the air at the Commandos football homecoming ceremonies in 1988. The pageantry was simply spectacular. This year's homecoming court included Cindy Sutton, Angie McKissick, Amy Barrow, Rachel Appleton, and Rachel Brugen. They were escorted by James Murph, Kevin Witt, Rocky Brawner, Brent LaCroix, Bill Oliver, and Trey Adams. It was a stunning court and the kind of night memories are made of. Hendersonville has always been known for excellence in our music programs. This year, the Commandos thrived under the direction of Jeffrey Phillips, and drum major Jessica Schenk led a band that performed with pride and precision. There was a lot of talent at Hendersonville in 1988, as anybody who heard the Commando band perform will tell you. The teachers, the students, sports, band, they all played a part in making 1988 a great year. But we all know what makes Hendersonville a great place to be, the food. And what goes great after a great meal? Sure, a good workout. Throughout the year, one of the hardest working groups around was Hendersonville Student Council. They showed true leadership as they helped organize dozens of activities and continued a tradition of scholastic excellence. This year's president was John Sieber, and other officers included Amy McLeod, Carl Davis, and Leslie Lacey. They did a great job all year long. Thanks, guys. This year's volleyball team was nothing short of fantastic. Finishing the year 13-20 and runner-up of the district, it was a season that kept our tradition strong in this great sport. There's something for everybody this year at Hendersonville. No matter where you turn, 1988 was a year that provided the crowds with some great entertainment.
Imagining your love, and I couldn't be still for nothing. My heart paced with a cloud.
Of course, one of the most popular sports at Hendersonville is basketball. This year, the boys' basketball team finished the season with a 12-12 record. Senior lettermen included Jeff Mathis, Bubba Seligman, Mark Lazenby, Chris Bates, and Brent Cothran. Eddie Greer led the Commandos and brought out a lot of cheers at Hendersonville. And this year's cheerleaders kept the spirit high at every game. Attendance was super this year as Hendersonville's girls basketball squad came in third in the district tournament and made it to the semifinals and regional play. Coach Jim Lind had 11 lettermen this year, including seniors Amy Smith and Tanya Holmquist. The team's 16-13 record this season proves the Commandos are still flying high in girls basketball. ...1988 had opportunities for every student. Our clubs and organizations pursued excellence in practically every field of endeavor, and the annual and newspaper staffs kept us on top of all the action. From tennis and wrestling to cross-country running and golf, Hendersonville athletics spanned the entire spectrum of sports, and 1988 proved we have star athletes in every category. Great going, guys. Of course, track and field is where individuals have a real opportunity to shine. Hendersonville's 1988 track team confirmed once and for all the talents of great individual athletes like Nicole Bibb, Amy Lucas, Keisha Isabel, Alicia Raymond, Sandy Hall, and William Glasser. A super year for track and field, and Hendersonville congratulates everybody who made this an exceptional season.
Fell into a theater of pain, waiting in the wings of pain, yeah.
1988 was a year to remember. The swim team, the tennis team, and the soccer team all had a great year. Baseball was another sport that Hendersonville played hard in 1988. Sonny McKellar set the school record in stolen bases and was also the leading hitter. Anthony Lake, Eric Corning, Jeff Odom, Gary Callagher, Jeff Mathis, Mike Gerlach, and Jimmy Craighead all contributed to a great team that completed the season 11-9 and went to the district tournament. In softball, the Commandos standouts were seniors Amy Smith, Amy Jo Key, Tina Lawman, Michelle Simmons, and Lisa Vance. the only thing left was to set it all to music, and the Commando Concert Band answered that challenge with a great season. The band performed everything from the classics to show music, and director Jeffrey Phillips blended the abilities of some very talented individuals into some beautiful harmonies. These very talented people proved that Hendersonville has a lot to be proud of. Vocal music was also a winner under the direction of Linda Tao. There's no business like show business, and if all the world's a stage, look out Broadway. This year's drama department produced several one acts and the school play The Hobbit, starring Bill Clifford. A great year in every way. The sports, the music, the clubs, and of course, the students. It was the students that made 1988 a great year. Yes, it was a great year, full of memories, like prom night. Speaking of unforgettable moments, how about graduation? 1988 was a great year, and from all of us at Hendersonville, good luck. We'll never forget you. Thank you.
summer, and I couldn't be still for nothing. My heart paced with a climb, and when the bus pulled in, well, I knew he'd be getting on.
This has definitely got to go in.
I'm gonna get my big belly.
Shoot, you girls have such good figures.
In the belly.
Sure that should have been with me out in California. I mean, you talk about
look at John. He cracks me up.
He heard a good friend.
John, y'all come on and get in the shot. Come on down and get in the shot. John wouldn't mind being remembered for posterity with all these women, would you, John?
In the middle, John.
Come on, John.
Show those legs, honey.
Show my legs, guys.
Y'all, this is going to be embarrassing when this comes out. Everybody's
going to
be looking.
I'm on her second.
Number one.
Perfect. Okay. Good.
Thank you.
way. Okay, good job. Okay, come on. Y'all getting out of shot. Come over here a little bit. Okay. Y'all two run back through one more time.
We erased what I taped earlier.
You erased the tape that I was on earlier?
Yeah, but I'm getting you again, okay? tell me. What is Hendersonville?
What's my favorite school?
No. What is Hendersonville High mean to you?
I love it.